Good morning, children. This is second lecture of our topic, Workforce and Energy. So in this lecture, we are going to study about simple machines. Machines are anything which makes our work easier. In our daily life also, we use various machines. So this is what we'll discuss in this second lecture, machines. First of all, we'll talk about the machines. Machines are basically anything like same machine which makes stitching of clothes easier and faster. So anything which makes our easy work easier, you can take an example of washing machine also. It also makes our work easier and faster to wash the clothes. We can take one more example. In our daily needs, we need scissors to cut the papers, clothes easily and very fast. Same with other household simple machines, we use some or the other work. So basically, if we ask what are machines, so machines are anything which makes our work easier and faster. They can be simple and complex also. So first of all, we'll be discussing some simple machines. Now simple machines, sewing machine and washing machine. And complex machines are made up of many parts. Now scissors, knives, tweezers, simple machines are made up of very few parts. You can see in your daily life also. So they have very simple parts. Now in this lecture, we'll be discussing about five types of simple machines. That is, complex machines are also made up of five types of simple machines. Now, one by one, we'll be discussing all these five types. First of all, number one, which is very important, is lever. Second is inclined plane. Third, screw. Fourth is pulley. Wheel and axle, which is also a type of machine, but though it is used maximum times in the earlier times, especially by the woodcutters and the carpenters. So that is not, we don't use in our daily life. Now basic machines which we are using are, number one is lever. Can you see, this is a type of rock. How do we move this rock? This is the question for you. Are you able to move such a heavy rock? No, obviously, because this is very heavy. So we have to think of an idea. Now, for example, I have put a very small stone, you can see, and there is a rod below it, below the stone, below this boulder. So this heavy rock, which we have to lift up, is called load. And below this rod, in the center somewhat, we have put a small stone again. We call it as fulcrum. And the tilted end upwards, that is called, where we'll put the force, is called effort. So this is a type of simple arrangement. One end of the rod is put under the boulder and boulder is load. You can see that has to be moved. Now how we will move it? We'll put a fulcrum in between this load and effort. Stone supports the rod and point at which stone and rod touch is fixed. And this is the fixed point, that is what we call the fulcrum. This is F, E stands for the effort and L stands for the load. So when you push down it on the opposite side, the boulder moves. This is because of the effort we have made. Now this type of arrangement where rod moves freely around the fulcrum is called lever. So this is the simple arrangement of a lever where you have put a fulcrum in between, load on one side, and the rod will lift this boulder whenever you'll pull an effort. So now this will make our work easier and easily we can move it. So basically on this basis, we can understand that levers are basically of three types and all the simple machines are depending on these type of levers, whether class one lever, class two lever or class three lever, that we will discuss in this. Now, first of all, we talk about first class lever. First class lever is somewhat the same arrangement as we can see on the screen. That is, load and effort on the either side of the fulcrum, and fulcrum will be in between. So the position will be according to the LFE. Fulcrum is between placed between load and effort. See, LFE, this will be the very simple way that you can learn also. You will not forget. You just have to memorize these diagrams here on the screen. First, you can see fulcrum is in between and effort and load is on the either side. So this is the arrangement as we saw in the seesaw, scissors, claw and hammer. So this type of arrangement comes in the category of class 1 lever. Now some pictures are there. You can see in the seesaw also two children are sitting. One, you can take it as a load. If the boy you are taking as a load, so girl is putting the effort. When the seesaw comes down from the girl side, that means effort has been made. So the load has been pulled up. And fulcrum, you can see this portion, this which is not able to move. This is immovable portion. We call it as fulcrum. In the hammer also, this is the load which you are going to pull. From the nail which you are going to pull, fulcrum, this portion, and effort you have to made it from this side. Same as I show you during the online class, in the scissors also, this is the fulcrum, which is the fixed point. Load is any paper or any cloth which you need to cut, and effort is the portion where you have to hold the scissor. So this effort, fulcrum, and load, this LFE arrangement comes in the class, first class lever. And these are few examples like seesaw, this hammer, scissors. These are falling in the category of first class lever. This fulcrum, you can see this yellow cursor. Wherever there is fulcrum, that portion is fixed. It will not move. Movable portions are only the effort and the load. Now we'll discuss about the second class lever. In this, what you have to memorize is FLE. Earlier it was LFE, now it is FLE, means load is in between, fulcrum on the either side and one side effort. So it is FLE. For example, wheelbarrow, bottle opener and nutcracker. These are few examples of second class lever. You can see the pictures as well. This wheelbarrow, you can see load is always in the middle and there is a fulcrum which is the fixed position, and effort has been given by the man who is carrying it. Same as in case of this nutcracker, load we have put in between, fulcrum on the mouth side that is attached will not move. Effort we are making with that, the help of our hand. So this is what we call effort. Now you see, this is your favorite drinks, the cold drinks, which normally you all are very used to. So whenever you can use bottle openers also. So effort you have to put from one side and they are fixed at, and load has to be put in between. Means wherever you want to open the bottle, the cap of the bottle, that has to be put in the middle, then only you are able to open it. So these three examples are given in the second category of levers, and for your convenience, it should, you have to learn like FLE or ELF, depends. So effort you will be going to put from one side, fulcrum will be there and load will be in between. So that this will be easier for you to learn also. That first class lever, we have fulcrum in between. In the second class lever, we have load in between. Now we'll be discussing about the third class lever, which also falls in the category of simple machines. So here comes the third class lever. Now what was left, already we have discussed about fulcrum and the load in between. So the last which is left is effort. Now effort falls in between in the third class lever. Load and fulcrum is on the either side of effort. For example, fishing rod, tweezers and tongs. Some pictures are given here. You can also have a look. Fulcrum, as I told you, will be the fixed position. load and effort. You have to put the effort in between. Then only you can hold the load at the last end. You can see in the pair of tongs also, this red side where fulcrum is attached. Here you can put the load in between, like your Maggi, your pasta, whatever you have to pick up with this tong. You can take this load in between and make some effort to hold it. Same you can see in the case of fishing rod also. So fulcrum is that portion which is attached. Effort will be in the between and load, which you have to just pull it up. Same is in the case of tongs. Also in the case of fishing rod, you can see fish that is like load is at the either end, and you are pulling effort in between. And fulcrum means the thread or this machine which is placed at the either end. So these are the three types of lever, the three categories in which once there is fulcrum in between, second there is load in between, and the third there is effort in between. So these simple designation of capital alphabets will help you to memorize very easily. Now, second category falls for the inclined plane. Children, you must have heard about the Egyptians. They built pyramids. Now, that time it was very difficult to do all this construction work because there were no machines at that time. So what happens? They use this inclined plane for the construction of pyramids. You can see the surface also, a little bit slanting from the side. So this slanting portion, which is like the slide, is called the inclined plane. This is straight from one side, you can see. It is like a sloping. It's a gentle slope that help us to move heavy loads with less effort. So it doesn't look like a machine, though it makes our work very easier. Here in this picture, you can see this. If you want to pull anything with a straight height. Now, for example, you want to pull this cylindrical portion up with, so you need, vertically you need full effort. But if the same cylinder you're going to put in this inclined plane, it will take less effort as the distance is increased. So vertically, it is very difficult to pull, but in case you want to slope it in the inclined plane and then hold, that then only half of your effort is required. So this is what the work of inclined plane. It helps to move gently in a slope and help us to move very heavy loads with very less effort. You can see this man is just pulling with the help of inclined plane. Plans placed to load trucks, ramp of hospitals, for wheelchairs, carved mountains on roads. These all are the examples of inclined planes. In the picture also you can see, it's very easy to lift these things to a higher, to the higher extent. So with the help of inclined plane, though the distance is increased, the effort has reduced to half and you don't have to use a lot of energy. Less effort is needed to go up with the help of inclined planes, though more distance is covered in this, but your effort will go to half. This is the basic function of our inclined plane. In the diagram also, you can see it very easily. This is the distance which is going to just change to half, and this is the diagram. Basically, we put for the inclined planes means the distance has increased of this sloping area. Next comes the category of screw. See, it looks like a nail with grooves cut in it, and you can call it as a groovy nail. You can see there's straight nail with so many inclined planes. It has winding edges called as thread, and this is an inclined plane. You can see this portion, they are just coming as inclined plane from the height, and just grooves are there. You see in this nail, It has a screw, has a groove for screwdriver. This is a star-shaped groove. So the same as the shape of the screwdriver, which can fit into the screw. Easily it can fit into the screw and is able to move it inside the wooden plank or inside any of the wall. So it is like the picture you can see. It is held against a piece of wood and its head is turned with the help of a screwdriver. The tip of the screw moves into the wood and it becomes very easier also. Less effort is needed than a nail due to its inclined edges. And because of the inclined edges, it works very simply to put it inside, also to pull it out. Screw holds the wood firmly because of its grooves and it goes inside. So this is what. Now you must have noticed whenever your father goes to a car mechanic for giving it on the service or for any repair, although you want to change the tire. So this is the simple arrangement of a screw. You call it as jack also. Whenever you put it inside below the car and you have to just rotate it from here, this portion, this jack will automatically lift upwards, okay? And your car, which is very heavy, it lifts upward. If you try it without this screw jack, it is very difficult to pull it up. So this is what we studied about few of the simple machines. Now we will discuss again in the recap. Simple machines we have studied. First was the lever. Second, as we studied about inclined plane. Third, we have studied about the screw. Then wheel and axle pulley. These are the simple machines. Now in lever also, we have studied about first class lever, that is fulcrum in between. Second class lever, that is load in between. Third class lever, that is effort in between. So this is what we have discussed now in this lesson. This topic, second topic of our lesson, workforce on energy. And this topic was all about machines. So I hope I have made myself clear in making you understand. We'll be proceeding for our next topic of the same lesson, Simple Machines Part 2, in the second lecture. Thank you so much.